Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra. Today I'm gonna teach you on how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today I'm gonna paint something like a landscape, but I'm gonna focus now everyone on the mountain part. I'm gonna make a beautiful mountain. I'm gonna create a mountain range, and I'm gonna put some houses also and a good landscape, okay? And please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed it, and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications on my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there are 5 limited colors, the brushes that we're gonna need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now, and I'm gonna do the underpainting first. So I have here the 1.5 inch flat brush. I'm gonna use some red and the blue to make some purple and then white. Yeah, I'll just make a beautiful faded sky, everyone. A little bit of light purple sky. And add some white here. Yeah, I'm thinking of adding one flat mountain here on the side, and a little cliff here, and then here will be flat, and then I'm gonna put some mountain here. Okay, we have here the blue and the red. And some white. I'm gonna put a far mountain here. There. I'm gonna improve more, I'm gonna make it taller. I'm gonna blend a little bit here. Yeah. So this will be my horizon here on the bottom part. The horizon will be really on the bottom part, everyone, like that. Because I want to see more on the mountains. I'm gonna mix a little bit darker now. Just blue and the red, everyone, to make some reddish purple and then white. Not so much dark, everyone. So here. So we have now our near mountain. there. There. See a little bit of stroke. This I like that, everyone. I like those stroke here. Sorry about the noises, everyone. There. So we have now a mountain range. I'm gonna make this a little bit more just deep. Here I'm gonna make it pointed. There, okay. On the bottom part, bro, I'm gonna make it darker. So blue and the red. And then I'm gonna put some white. Not so much dark. So this will be the horizon. Then it will be darker here. Okay. And you can also put some mountain range here. So you have now this series of colors, everyone. You can see from light to dark. So that's good. We know which part we're gonna put those near or the far part. Okay. So this clip here, I'm gonna make it lighter. So I'm gonna make it greenish also. So I'm gonna use blue and the yellow, and with the blue umber. This one will be greenish and darker. And here also, everyone, I'm gonna make this dark. And then I'm gonna make this raw umber. Okay, there you go. And then here in the bottom part, I'm gonna make it a field, but I will try to make it orange first. There. So I think this will be just a very easy landscape, everyone. Just, you can see just a simple elements there. There you go. So we have now the basic composition of our landscape. So I think it's already dry now. So yeah, some parts are still wet. But I'm gonna start now adding some details on the mountain part first. I am going to add first details on the sky. I think I'm gonna do later on the sky because I just want to let it like that. Some gray, yes, but a little bit of white maybe. And then down to the mountain. So yeah, I'm gonna need to make sure that we can see clearly the mountains, okay? Okay. So let's add some white colors on the sky first. I'm gonna use this medium size flat brush number 8. I have here the plain white color. So yeah, you can do like that if you want. There, okay. Just lines of white, and it can create an illusion of clouds. Okay, there you go. So yeah, that's it. So it's just very simple sky with some little bit of whites for the clouds. So here I'm gonna try to add some shades here on this light blue mountain brown. So I'm gonna make it a little bit brownish. Okay, so I have here the raw umber and then some white. No, that's still too dark, everyone. I'm gonna put more white because we need to put a lighter color. So just a little bit. Now I'll just try to retouch that later on, everyone. So I'm gonna proceed here on this one. So I'm gonna make it a little bit darker. So I'm gonna make the top part a little bit brownish. These are some rocks on the top of the mountain, everyone. There are some rocks there on the top. Our light will be on the left side. Yeah, so we are putting first the dark part. Our light source will be on the left side. There, okay. Now let's add some greenish. So I'm gonna put blue, green, from blue, a little bit of yellow, and then white. Darker.
Now let's put some greenish on the other side. So these are grasses or even the trees here, so it's always greenish. Now let's, I'm very excited with the highlights, everyone. So I'm gonna put more yellow, a little bit of orange there, and then white, more blue green there, and then let's start it here. Stopping technique, everyone. There. Okay. This brighter. Just stop your technique, everyone. There, so I'm gonna try to make it much more blue green, everyone. Blue, and then yellow, and then white. so it looks like that. Still a little bit bluish. So make it a bit bluish, everyone. And then I'm going to add using the smaller brush, the smaller number 2 Nylon flat brush. I'm gonna use much more orange with the raw umber and then white. So let's add the highlights here. Okay, that's good. So I like the top mountain front looks good, and yeah, it looks so far greenish. Okay, yeah, I like the tone, everyone. You can really see that this mountain are far from us. Okay, so I think I'm gonna retouch the farther mountain, make it much greenish. I think we need more work there. This mountain, yeah, it just looks simple. Okay, so let's add a little bit greenish here because I think yes. It's a little bit light greenish, so I think I need more white. I think just need much more bluish, everyone. You can add much more bluish color. There, and then I'm gonna add some white. So at least you can see a bit of greenish tone here. Even it's not so much obvious, but it's still greenish. Let's also put a little bit bluish here. Shadow one. then I'm gonna put some blue. Just a tacky technique. So you can see now that it's a forest, it's a lush green forest. Okay, so here also Iguan, I'm gonna try not to put more here. So I'm gonna try to put much more bold colors here. So to make way. First let's put some cliff there also, blue, umber and white. So I'll just try to add much more better greenish there. Again, everyone, I just use the copying technique. You can use the light greenish here on the top. Or you can add much more bluish. Just tapping technique, everyone, to create more like a forest or some sort of trees. So I will do my best, everyone, to add a lot of details here. Just a tiny dots like that. But today it will create an impression that they look like forests or trees. Okay. And here also, everyone, I need to put also some tinier greenish here, but not so much visible. At least you can see a little bit of greens there. So there's, as you can see now, everything turns out to be developing something like that, and it become much better to look in the far. Stop and think anymore. Actually, I'm sweating now. My room is still very, very hot. There, and then I'm gonna apply now the highlights. Yellow and the blue. And then white. Start here. So just double technique, everyone. Also here, so highlights on the trees and the forest. Actually, this is just a simple brush strokes and color mixing technique, everyone. All you have to do is two more on this part.
I'm gonna put yellowish or even a little bit orange and blue. So we can make a little bit of different color, but brighter, everyone. I'm gonna put some white. and then much more blue. I'm sweating, everyone. I'm gonna make this part a little bit brighter. Okay. So that's it. So I think that will be enough, and you can see now the lights striking on this part. And also here we're gonna put some also trees there, but I'm gonna use a bigger brush. So I have here the raw umber, a little bit of red. I'm gonna put some reddish trees also here. There. Now let's add some light greens. This one may be trees a bit nearer to us. There, so I like these trees, everyone. Yeah, it's a bit different there. There's a forest here on the bottom part of this mountain. So yeah, we can see those trees are a bit different. Okay, so I'm gonna try to put details now on this mountain, everyone. So I'm gonna put some houses there. Okay, so I'm gonna put also some cliff. So I have here the raw umber with the white. I'm gonna add light brown. There, okay. Okay. Okay, so now I'm gonna try to put some brushes there, or even something that I found on the cliff, some bushes or whatever. Yellow and the blue, and then I have here the raw umber. Okay. Tapping technique, everyone. I'm gonna put houses here later on. There, okay. So just tapping technique, everyone, and you can create good details. And then I'm gonna try to add grasses on the top. Just yellow and the white. There, okay. Yeah, it looks good. You can see now the light there. Okay. I'm gonna try this orange, everyone, and then white. I'm gonna try to add now here on the bottom, on the horizon. You can add also white. There. Red and the yellow. And then brown. So I'm gonna try to add a little bit of brownish here also. It should be, the color should be balanced, everyone, not just greenish, but also you can put a bit of orange and brownish. And then you can put some orange, or some yellow, pure yellow. Some yellow here. Just topping technique, everyone. I think it's not so hard to create this. What I like about this one is it's broken. The more your bristle flat brush broken on the tip of its hair, so it will be the better the result of your tapping technique. So the texture will become much better. So always remember that also. There. So the painting is almost complete. I want to put houses, everyone. Those native houses here on this cliff and even on the bottom part. I want to make it look like a complete landscape with the houses everywhere. So I'm gonna use this small flat brush, and then I'm gonna use a little bit of yellow and the red, and then some white. You can use even smaller brushes, everyone. Then I'm gonna mix for a little bit darker. So these are different houses. These are native houses, everyone. I found this cliff, so usually it will look like that. So you can see that there's a lot of houses, and also here. one, I'm going to use now this small liner brush to create a much more smaller details. This one, so I'm gonna use this white mixed with this lighter blush color or light brown. So we can see now multiple native houses. Also, I need to put some doors and windows using the umber. So we can put doors here. So yeah, it looks like there are people also there living on that place. Like some sort of village, small village there. Okay. Yeah, I'll just try to retouch, and I think I will be finished, everyone. This is just very, very simple landscape focusing on the mountains and the small details of the houses. Okay, so I'll just try to retouch, everyone. Try to add some details or lights on the clip here. There you go. There, okay. Let's add more, trees there, everyone, or something like anything there to complete the painting. So just light green, some bushes, actually. Add more bushes. yellow and then white. You can add more light yellow. Maybe some grasses there. You can also put some trees there. Tree trunk. Okay. Also here, or dead tree. There, okay. And then on the also here, everyone, let's put some trees, some tree trunk also. So it looks like that it's a forest there also. Okay, so yeah, it looks good, everyone. I like the color there in the this village part. It looks like there will be a lot of people there. Okay, so yeah, this painting is just so simple, but I like those details. It looks realistic. Okay, so I'll just try to retouch and I think I'll be finished. I will just try to retouch, adding some more bushes, everyone, and I am finished. Okay, I'm done. So just here, maybe I will just try to make the color of the yellow and the red. Here, everyone, on the on these houses, make it much brownish. And then I will just try to add some more bushes and I am finished, everyone. So I have here the blue and the yellow. Bring it together and I'm gonna put more yellow. And then let's put So I'll just try to add more pushes. There, and I am done. Okay, so I think I am finished, everyone. I like everything there. I like the simplicity of this painting, but it looks good, it looks fresh, it looks different than my other works. Okay, I focus morely on the mountains on this painting, and it looks good. Okay
everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.